Hello everyone, I Meenakshi Bajaj welcome you to my channel. As you already know that I am going to discuss the entire subject of HRM with you in series of video lectures. Today I am going to start with the functions of HRM part 2. The link of the previous video lecture has been provided in the description box, so I suggest you to please listen to that video lecture first, only then you will be able to gain full clarity of this video lecture. In today's video lecture, we will discuss operative functions of human resource management. To explain the topic thoroughly, I am going to include many examples for your easy understanding. My dear learner, if you are new to my channel, then be sure to subscribe. Turn on the notification bell to get notified when I upload a new video. As you can see in the slide, there are managerial functions and operative functions. Managerial functions have already been discussed by me in the previous video lecture. Today we will be focusing on operative functions. There are 5 operative functions. In case of operative functions, the focus is on the task which the HR department has to do. The concern is with specific activities. How different activities are to be performed to overcome all the problems and achieve the organizational objectives. Now you must be wondering that what is the basic difference, why these categories have been framed. The basic difference is the managerial functions are for the overall organization. But when we talk of the operative functions, they are about specific tasks. Every task has a major objective and efforts are done to achieve that task in the best possible way. Let's start with the procurement function. Procurement function is about securing and employing right kind of people. It is very important to understand that right number of people should be appointed in the organization. If the number doesn't match with the requirements, there can be problems in the organization. When the HR manager performs procurement function, he has to estimate that what are the manpower requirements, how many people or how many employees are required in the organization. Accordingly, he has to plan many other tasks: recruitment, selection, and then final placement of the human resources. To understand the procurement function, we will discuss an example. Here the example is about Shri Industries. It is a very famous fashion house which is manufacturing ladies' traditional clothes. Now the company is planning for expansion. They want to launch a new project that is about launching ladies' jewelry. For that, they need young and energetic staff who also have creative ideas. Now this task has been assigned to Ms. Saru, who is working as HR manager in Shri Industries. Now, Ms. Saru has to perform the procurement function. What activities she has to perform? Let's see. Firstly, she has to do job analysis. In job analysis, she will study all the operations in detail. What are the responsibilities that are involved in each job? Nature of job. What kind of people are required for that job? Entire job descriptions and job specifications are prepared by her. After that, she is well aware that what are the job requirements. Accordingly, she will start with human resource planning. I have told you the meaning of human resource planning in the previous video lecture. In this, she will estimate the present and future requirements. What will be the requirement of people? She will prepare a proper inventory. How many number of employees are there in the organization right now? Accordingly, she will formulate the action programs. to bridge the gap between the requirements and current inventory. Once she is done with it, accordingly she will see that is there a need for more people? If the answer is yes, she has to move forward for recruitment. She will search for the new sources from where she can stimulate people to apply for the job. She has to strike a balance between the internal and external sources of recruitment. She was able to generate a good pool of applications. From those applications, she will do selection. She will judge. This will depend upon her ability, suitability of different candidates according to the job specifications. She will choose the most appropriate person. After that, she has to place that person according to his skills, that is assigning them appropriate job. While doing this, she has to see that everyone goes through induction or orientation. With this, she makes the new employees familiar with the organization's work environment. In this way, every manager has to work on every aspect to make the project successful. Once the HR manager is successful in getting right kind of people to the organization, he has to work for the development of those employees. This results into second operative function, that is development. We all know that learning is a never-ending process. Business is also changing, that too at a rapid pace. This results in improving the knowledge, skills and aptitude of the employees. Only then they will be able to perform on present jobs, and in future if they get promotion, they will be able to deal with it with the help of development only. This results into upgradation of the employees. Now, how this upgradation can be done? This can be done by providing proper training and development opportunities. Now, let's understand this function with the help of an example. When development function is performed by the HR manager, the very first activity which he has to do is about performance and potential appraisal. He has to do systematic evaluation of the employee's performance. With that evaluation, he is able to judge the potential for development. In the present example, the HR manager has done so. And what is he saying? He is telling to the employee that you are a bright software engineer and you have executed your job in an excellent way. In this way, he sees that this person or this employee has a potential for promotion. Accordingly, he is offering her training. He is saying, to polish your skills further, we offer you to enroll into an advanced course in a reputed foreign university. This is a great opportunity for an employee. This is also called executive development. The employee is also very happy. She is saying it's a great opportunity to enhance my knowledge. It will help me in my career too. Thus, with the help of development function, career planning is done. Human resources can have promotions and even transfers at their desired locations. After development, another important function is compensation. Compensation is a very important factor in case of employee motivation. The focus here is on determination that how compensation should be fixed for every job. One thing is very important, that whatsoever compensation the company has fixed, it should be adequate and equitable. Only then the employee will work. He will contribute for the attainment of the organizational goals. Equitable compensation should be there for same level of employees. There should be no discrimination on the basis of gender, race or religion. In this function, the HR manager has to perform three main activities. The very first is job evaluation. He has to see that what is the worth of a job. More the important job, more will be the compensation. Second is about wage and salary administration. Surveys should be conducted. Employees should be asked that what should be the wage and salary structure. Competitors should be studied. Only then decisions should be taken. Third is bonus. In India, there is Bonus Act 1965. Accordingly, the bonus should be declared time to time. Moreover, if a company is gaining profits because of the efficient working of the employees, they can offer non-statutory bonus. Many other type of incentives can also be introduced for the betterment and increasing the efficiency of the employees. Next comes integration function. Integration function is all about reconciling. The goals of the organization should be perfectly matched with the goals of the members. Proper industrial relations should be maintained. Every HR manager should try to maintain good industrial relations. If the company works for the betterment of the employees, this will result into sense of belongingness. Positive feelings will be there in the minds of the employees. They will work in harmony. Channels of communications will be open. Employees will give their feedback. Accordingly, the company will reframe its policies. Many a times there are grievances. Employees face different types of organization, problems in the organization. The HR manager has to redress all these grievances. In this function, the HR manager tries to motivate its employees. He do this with many things like different types of financial and non-financial rewards are offered to the employees. Incentive schemes are launched. Whenever the manager finds that there is some type of conflict going in the organization, he tries to resolve that conflict as early as possible. Quality of work life is improved. Different types of amenities are offered to the employees. There can be a formal committee which always tries to resolve the grievances that the employees are facing. As today's life is stressful, employee counseling can be done. There can be many efforts to develop sound human relations. So, in integration function, participation of employees is increased. Discipline is also maintained in the organization. After that, the next function is maintenance. Maintenance function is concerned with protecting and promoting both physical and mental health of the employees. Several type of benefits can be given to them. We can start with healthy working conditions. The working conditions are very important. They should be neat and healthy working environment. A positive feeling should be there in the minds of the employees. Health standards should be maintained. There should be safety standards as regard to fire or other things. Sanitation should be there. Only then the employees will feel that their health is important in the eyes of the organization. Different type of fringe benefits can be given to the employees. For example, they can be given housing facility, medical aid, educational facilities for their children, conveyance facilities. In this way, the organization can also plan for giving social security to its employees. There is a life after retirement too. So provide the employees a sense of security by provident fund, pension, gratuity. Even the working woman should be provided maternity benefits. Welfare schemes should be designed. Human resource research can be done for the needs and requirements of the employees. Auditing should be done. When to rechange all these facilities. With this, our topic is complete, and I hope that all your doubts were clear. So stay connected, like, share, and subscribe.